First World Order Radio. Finally, we are on the air. No doubt. All right. There's always gonna be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. We get on into some of that order consciousness tonight. First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m. We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet. There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday at 8 o'clock, we are now going to make this the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it. Burn. Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns and existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. Order. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Radio. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, these clues are given throughout the various languages for us to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories, shit that works.
All right, peace. Once again, with First World Order Radio, and we back. And we getting ready to bring on my co-host, Brother L. You here?
Peace, God. I'm here.
All right. Glad you got a chance to come on. We had a little bit of technical difficulties, but we here. We made it. So we're going to get into this topic tonight, and that the Federal Reserve owns you. All right?
All right.
All right. So we're going to go back to the original Constitution for the United States of America. In which that states Article 1, Section 8, Clause 5, that Congress shall have power to coin money, regulate the value thereof, and of foreign coin. Article 1, Section 10, Clause 1 states, no state shall make anything but gold or silver coin as legal tender. All right? So, what you think about that right there, brother? Grand Sheik, concerning that particular matter.
Yeah. Well, it showed that real money is not real until it's backed by gold or silver.
Right.
You've been calling yourself paying the bills off, you ain't paid nothing off. You ain't paid no rent. You ain't paid no car notes. You ain't paid no electric bill. You never made any money.
True.
To do that. So it's all a fraud. You're living the fraud. You're living on debt. Debt on top of debt. Therefore, the more debt you spend, the higher the deficit rises.
True. That's true.
That's right, because a lot of people don't really understand that. You don't pay it, but you discharge it. It can be discharged, but it can never be paid. You're talking about balancing the budget. The budget, it's just a game, just to keep people working harder and harder, so a lot of their wealth will be collected by the few.
So you're seeing that. That basically you have a working class or a subordinate class in which that has to deal with in which that basically they eat from the crumbs of the master table. And the masters, those who are the so-called rich elite, in which that is making money from those in which that are working. Well, I mean, when you think that it has something to do with the drive of an individual, or is that something which that is a planned scheme? I mean, does so-called white supremacy play a part in that, you know, which that whole aspect of the population down until we end up revolting, like, you know, the civil rights movement with the sit-ins, with the boycotts, you know, just like, you know, the marches and things in which that is even taking place today. I mean, how you feel about that, brother?
Well, like you said, that the white supremacy plays a big part in that. Well, yes, it does, big time. But a lot of people got to understand what white supremacy really is. It's not just talking about being for supporting so-called white people. It's about supporting and the benefit of the elite, as you said before. You've got a lot of people out here that think just because they are so-called white that they're in. You know, they're in. They're not in. Majority of them are not in. A majority of them are not bloodline to royalty.
Uh-oh.
Especially the British royalty.
Right.
A lot of them are not. A lot of them have birth certificates, which resides with the 14th Amendment.
Right, right.
And a lot of them don't know, that resides with the 14th Amendment, which is a fraud, that it was never properly ratified. They're about in the same boat for that part as same as the so-called black people. Same boat, you know, because if they stop the voting rights, which is supposed to be signed every 25 years by, if, you know, president, whatever president is in office at the time, if they don't sign it, then that more likely that probably will affect them also. Because they're U.S. citizens.
Right, right.
And when they start getting birth certificates for their offsprings, and well, that was it. They had no more rights neither. They gave their rights away. But
right.
They think they're better than the so-called black people. But I say, boy, are they being misled.
That's true.
Yes, sir.
So,
go ahead.
Right. So we know that the Federal Reserve Bank was formed through the Federal Reserve Act, you know, but in 1913 on Jackal Island, which is off the coast of Georgia.
Mm-hmm.
The Federal Bank, you know what I'm saying, was a private banking system, you know, put together by approximately 8 families.
Exactly.
You know, that will regulate the amount of the money that the United States government will allow to borrow and put in circulation. Even though that
exactly.
was supposed to be the rule of Congress, as we just finished stating and reading, you know, in the Constitution itself. You know, so we know that by 1933, Franklin D. Delano Roosevelt took the money from off the gold standard. By 1972, Richard Nixon took the money from off the silver standard. And ever since, the money have not been backed by anything worth of substance. As a matter of fact, the same 4 pennies in which that it takes in order to print the $1 bills is the same 4 pennies that it takes to the $5 bills, the $10 bills, the $20
mm-hmm.
bills, the $5 bills, and the $100 bills, and et cetera.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Right, right. So, you know, when you go back and study that, you find, you know, how that all correlates. And in particular, you know, we're talking about, you know, in 1933, how the United States went bankrupt, you know, how it was unable to pay its debt, and the country was bankrupt, basically, and the private banks that made up the Federal Reserve demanded their money, and Roosevelt responded, you know, and he had to use the only thing left of any value to pay the banks and continue doing business with them, and that's the citizens of the country.
Exactly.
But yeah, we was never citizens, so we got bought into the fraud because we were just recently released from out of so-called slavery, 1865.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so within a matter of less than just 50 years or so, we the formation of the Federal Reserve Bank, you know, and then within, 60 years or so, you see the formation, of the money, the fiat notes coming into circulation, no longer being backed by anything or substance, So how exactly was all of this orchestrated is a little lengthy, but we won't get into as much as we possibly can. But the original birth or naturalization records for every United States citizen is on file in the official record in Washington, D.C., and the properties and assets of every living United States citizen is pledged as collateral for the national debt.
Mm-hmm.
But as if you are, and if you declare yourself to be a U.S. citizen, we know that the United States is nothing more than a 40-mile radius of Washington, D.C.
Yeah, exactly.
Right? But that has nothing to do with the Americans, who actually, there's actually only one real American citizen, and that's with those who had property rights, in which that is shown through the particular case, or cases of 1848, in 1850 with the Turner family, in which that you have Henry Turner versus the United States, and you have the heirs of Henry Turner versus the United States. You also have the King versus the United States, in which that all three speaks about the Turner or the Washita proper, in which that was never part of the original property or assets of the United States. They are now utilized an eminent domain, our ignorance, in order to perpetrate this fraud.
Mm-hmm.
So we find out that being that the so-called United States citizens was pledged as collateral for the national debt,
mm-hmm.
within just weeks, the certificates of live claim birth in which that was filed at Washington, D.C., this evidence revealed that there is even a federal children department established by the Shepard Townsend Act of 1922 under the Department of Commerce that appears to be involved in the process of some way that every citizen is given a number, which is the red number on the birth certificate, which is a bond number, and mm-hmm. each live birth is valued at about $650,000 to more than $1.6 million Federal Reserve dollars in collateral for the feds. So,
wow.
When you go to the IRS, you can see this with the IRC, which is the Internal Revenue Code, in which that specifically states that at birth, a child is worth $650,000. And, of course, that symbolizes the child being, the weight of the child, that of gold. In other words, you are worth your weight in gold. So let's say right now, gold is between $1,500 to $2,000 in value right now for 1 ounce of gold, right? Right? So right now, gold is about $1,700 an ounce right now, currently. Now, let's chop off the $700. Let's just use $1,000. Let's say gold is worth $1,000 an ounce. If a child weighs 10 pounds, all right, and mm-hmm. comes out the womb 10 pounds, all right? Each pound is 16 ounces. So 1 ounce is $1,000, and then you times that with 16, right? You times mm-hmm. that with 10. Then you fractionalize it because the bank marks up 10 times the value. By the time you finish, that child is worth, in which that weighs 10 pounds, is worth $1.6 million.
Wow.
That's at gold being $1,000. Of course, gold is $1,700 right now, approximately $1,700 an ounce. So we're looking at a child which weighs 10 pounds worth $2 million in value or more.
Mm.
Okay? So, that's at birth. What you think happens at the time in which that they mature and turns 18? That's what they call 18 is the maturity time. This is time when you get the right to vote. This is the time when you already have your license to drive. This is the time in which that you are able to, well, at least you was able to smoke. You're not able to drink until you turn 21 nowadays. But now it's like you graduate from high school, and now you're able to get a job or et cetera and work on your own, move into your own place. In other words, you're grown. So now you come to maturity. Well, the same things happens when you put your name on the voting card and you start voting, and you also do the, for the males, they do the selective service for the military.
Yeah.
All of those are contracts or adhesive contracts in which that symbolizes your maturity. So now your value goes up from $2 million to approximately $200 million.
Ooh.
Okay?
Man.
All right? So, and the crazy part is that they use your birth certificate as bundles, like mutual funds and bunch bundle bonds, in which that gets sold by other countries or to a country, such as to China. So you may find your birth certificate in China, owned by a Chinese company or a Japanese company. And you was able at one time to go into www.fidelity.com, in which that they have changed it now, but you was able to go there and actually put in your information at one time. This was approximately about 4 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
Now they have stopped doing it because so many knuckleheads have gone there, and they, you know, blew up the line, and then, you know, basically told them that, you know, that the people at the grassroots level know of the plan in which that they have. And so they end up changing it. And so now you're no longer able to get into www.fidelity.com and into your information, you know, unless you have an account. All right. So since that was blown up, there's some in which they claim that there's a way to get into the back office. But when you would be able to go to www.fidelity.com, you was able to click on research, click on quote, then click on symbol lookup, and then type in your birth, a number on your birth certificate with the dashes, you know what I'm saying, or either your social security number with the dashes or the back of the social security card, and they would give you the QSIP number, the auto TRIS number. They would give you how much you was worth and had your bond, which is your birth certificate. So how much you was worth on the open market. So that means that they are using your bond, which is your birth certificate, as chattel or cattle property. And you are the cattle. You are the slave. And your mother sold you into slavery. As a matter of fact, on some of your birth certificates, you will see that it states under the name of mother, informant.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Now you look at the word informant. What does the word informant mean? on the streets nowadays, we call it a snitch.
Right.
An informant is an agent. Well, that takes me back to the Matrix, where Morpheus was talking to Neo after Neo was looking at the girl in the red dress. And he said, Neo, were you paying to me or were you looking at the woman in the red dress? You know, and the whole science is that he stated that there's teachers, lawyers, businessmen, politicians, etc. And they're all a facet of this matrix. And what he said, and they're all potential agents. That they're all potential agents. So, that's the same thing. As long as you have nothing on the record in which that denies what they have put on the record, on the public record, which is the birth certificate, and you don't have anything such as a live claim birth form or a baptismal record, then you are at the behest of them. And if you have never put in a denial of corporate status or a negative avertment, then you have never done anything in order to debate or rebut what they have put on the public record. So therefore, you are what they say you are. Hence, you are a 14th Amendment citizen. Hence, you are a U.S. citizen. So therefore, being that you're a U.S. citizen, that means you are collateral. It means you are, it means you can be an asset or you can be a problem. But either way, they're going to extract the money from you if it's going to be by way of out your pockets or by way of putting you in the prison system, you being on parole or you being on probation, or you serving actual years, months, days in the prison system, in which that is ran by the correction, all right, corporation, the correctional corporation.
Wow.
Payne Webber is actually the United States when you go into, that's who the prosecutor, that's who they pretend to be the state. The district attorney, the assistant district attorney, they all work for Payne Webber, which is an insurance company in which that issues forth bonds or market bonds and promissory notes and so forth and so on.
Mm-hmm.
These are insurance policies. And the birth certificate is an insurance policy.
Mm.
All right? It's an insurance policy in which they never told you about, in which that's attached to an exemption account, which is via your Social Security card. The front numbers without the dashes is your exemption number. The number, which is the password, is on the back of your Social Security card. All right? That's the back of your Social Security card. Now, most of you don't even know what those numbers mean on the back. All right? You don't know what the letter means on the back. All
right? Right.
And that's a problem. So we're going to break it down for you tonight. All right? If you have A at the beginning of the number on the back, which is oftentimes in red, I've seen it in green, I've seen it in black, but nowadays it's in red.
Right.
You have new card. Okay? So, if you have an A before the numbers, then that is the Boston Federal Reserve Bank. If you have a B before the numbers, that's New York Reserve Bank. C, Philadelphia Reserve Bank. D, Cleveland Reserve Bank. E, Richmond, Virginia Reserve Bank. F, Atlanta, Georgia Reserve Bank. G, Chicago Reserve Bank. H, St. Louis, all right, Missouri Reserve Bank.
Yeah, Massachusetts, Chicago.
I, if you have an I before the numbers, is Minnesota or Minneapolis, Minnesota Reserve Bank. If you have a J, then that's Kansas City Reserve Bank. If it has a K, then that's Dallas Reserve Bank. If it's an L, then that's San Francisco Reserve Bank. These are all the Federal Reserve routing information. All right? You can go to www.feddirectory.frb.org.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So, that's what those particular letters mean on the back. All right? They are attached to a Federal Reserve Bank. These are the places in which that, based on your card, it tells you what the funds are leaving out at through your exemption. That's what this means. So, like, for example, I have S. So, mine is in Atlanta, Georgia. All right? What's yours, brother? What's yours, brother L?
Mine's a G.
All right.
G. So that'd be Chicago.
Right, exactly. So yours is right there in Chicago. So this is how you know this is all tied in. Look on your birth certificate. Look at the lower left-hand corner, and you will see the word American Bank Note Company. American Bank Note Company. Or it might say Midwest Bank Note Company. But the fact is that it's attached to a bank, that this bond, because it's on bond paper, is your birth certificate and has a bond number, which is the upper which is the red number in the upper right left hand corner. And then it has your birth number, all right, in the upper right-hand corner. And then on the lower left-hand corner, it has American Bank Note Company. So, if you ask, let's go to Wikipedia. As a matter of fact, if you go to Wikipedia, it might give us a clue on this bank note company, American Bank Note Company. All right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's go. Yeah, go ahead, Brother Al.
Boy, that gives a new name to crime against humanity. Maybe that's an understatement.
Yeah.
You know, if the people just wake up and really realize what's going on, what's happening to them, man, woo, man, oh.
yeah. So, but before I get to that explanation of the American Bank Note Company, let's get to what a bond is, because that's what your birth certificate is. A bond is a bank note, is a warehouse receipt. All of these things, that's what it is. It's chattel papers. Okay, it's chattel papers. So we look at bond, and it says an unusual formal written agreement by which a person undertakes to perform a certain act and fulfill the obligations of a contract with the conditions that failure to perform or obtain will obligate the person to pay a sum of money or will result in the forfeiture of money put up by the person or surety. So the United States government is saying that they put up this birth certificate, this bond, as surety, and they control it. And if you violate it, you pay the repercussions for it, for what they set up, without ever telling you, without ever giving you a consent in the matter. They didn't tell your mother that this is what they was going to do. So,
no.
We go. Right, they didn't tell you. So it
Hell
says an
no.
interest-bearing document. Check this out now. An interest-bearing document giving evidence of a debt issued by a government body or corporation that is something secured by a lien on property and is often designed to take care of a particular financial need. And this is from Merriam-Webster Dictionary of Law, 1996. So it says that secured by a lien on property. So the birth certificate, being as a bond, it is also a lien.
Lien on property also, right?
Right, lien on property. What's the property? Your physical body.
Uh-huh.
Hence, you being chattel, or which is nothing more than a French word, which means cattle. You it. You the burden of beasts. The beast burden.
Huh.
You must bear the yoke. You must bear the cross. That's what all it symbolizes in the religious terminology. So what is a banknote? Being that we just said that it says Midwest Banknote Company or American Banknote Company in the lower left-hand side of your birth certificate. What does it say? A kind of negotiable instrument. So not only is the birth certificate is a bond, it's also a lien on property, but it is also a negotiable instrument. We don't tap some shit now.
Oh, yeah.
Look up negotiable instruments. A negotiable instrument is a promissory note made by a bank payable to the bearer on demand, used as money, and in many jurisdictions is legal tender. Along with coins, banknotes make up the cash and bearer form of all modern money. So this banknote receipt, this banknote negotiable instrument, this banknote bond, this banknote lien, this birth certificate has value.
Yes, sir.
That is what you can use in order to remove your debts is by utilizing the same debt instrument in which that got your ass into the problem in the first place.
Exactly. Man.
Because it's a negotiable instrument, a promissory note. Now, why would you get rid of a negotiable instrument, a promissory note? Because I have heard jackasses out there in which that have stated that they want to revoke or make null and void their birth certificate. Then you don't have anything to discharge debt in this current UCC, which is Uniform Commercial Code venue, which is national and international. Every state in the so-called union uses the UCC.
Better
so you're saying that you're not participating in no commerce, but yet you don't have a goddamn bank. You don't have a grocery store. You don't have a distribution center. You don't even make or manufacture your own clothes. Hell, niggas, you don't even pick cotton any longer.
That's right.
To even get the raw material to make clothes, to make toilet paper to wipe your ass.
Exactly.
So that means you don't have a pot to piss in, nor a window to throw it out of. So stop with the dumb shit. You don't use it. You don't use the UCC. You don't. Well, I let your dumb ass keep thinking that you don't and won't. And let's see what happens when they start putting together or utilizing these debt prisons that they have. Let's see what happens when you have over $10,000 in debt and they start putting your monkey asses in these concentration camps, these containment centers, these FEMA camps, these quote-unquote debt prisons. You don't use it. Okay, well, you don't use it. Let's see what happens. Because you don't have anything in order to use to make a superior claim of lien. That's what a UCC is. It protects your property and your assets. That's what it does. Protects your property and your assets. It's a notice of a claim of lien. Now, you also will attach an affidavit of a claim of lien, which is common law, along with that, if you are intelligent. As well as a copyright, trademark, trade name, security agreement, full harmless indemnity clause, private agreement. And your collateral listing is based on all your property and all your assets, everything that you have acquired herein or hereafter, along with your negative avertment, your grant and power of attorney, your affidavit of bond for discharge.
Mm-hmm.
All right. If you want to send it to Jacob Lew, who's the United States Secretary of Treasury, then you would add certain bonds to it, such as a silver bond certificate. You would add a private bond set off. You would add a charge back. You would add a bill of exchange. All negotiable instruments, along with a copy of your birth certificate, stamped at a 45-degree angle of accepted for value, front and back, along also with, well, we did back in the days use also the Social Security card. We did that also at a 45-degree angle, front and back. But you would send all this little package to Jacob Lew, who's the United States Secretary of Treasury, in order to tell him that within 30 days you would begin to start discharging your debts. So now you're no longer a collateral. Right? What do collateral mean to you, brother L? What do a person who is a collateral?
Collateral is like an insurance or something to pay off a debt. Energy, your labor. Which is what they're using to pay out what they so-called national debt, which does not exist.
Right, so we are collateral. But what's the negative point of view of the word collateral? You heard of the word collateral damage?
Yeah.
You heard of the word collateral damage, right?
Oh, yeah.
All right, so in the military, when they call collateral damage is what?
It's called, they call it casualties.
Exactly. You got it. Thank you, Brother L. That's all I needed to know.
Yes, sir.
say it one more time for the audience where they can figure this shit out.
Casualties. Casualties of war.
Casualties of war. So collateral damage, collateral, means a casualty of war. So that means that you are no longer participating in the war.
Exactly.
But I know y'all are so confused. There's so many bullshit artists out there that's not telling you the truth, because they'd rather you sign up with them in some type, form, and fashion and get your nationality, and also to be able to do some type of form of commerce. And everybody have their own little methods and procedure. But yet, if they're not telling you what we're telling you, then they bullshit artists. And y'all better get away from them as soon as possible.
Yes, sir.
Because they're leading you down the wrong path. All right? There's no way in order to protect your individual properties and assets and commerce unless you do it by way of shielding yourself, such as utilizing a corporation. Some use an unincorporated association. Some use a LLC. Some type of front, preferably a religious front. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And this is how you do it. And that offers you also not just protection of your property and assets, but also religious protection, in which that is also stated within the First Amendment, in which that states that you have the freedom of religion. But also, Congress can't legislate any laws concerning it. This is also in the Constitution. So, that gives you more of a ability in order to take your land, take your house, take automobiles, and place them all under your religious protection. Bless you. Under your religious protection. All right? Or your religious affiliation. These are just some of the sciences here. All right? Now, if you have an organization which that is claiming that they're going to do all of this, and then they put it under their organization, and as if you can probably trust them to do so, if you think you can trust them to do so, then be my guest. However, for those that want to protect their own individual property and assets, and want to form their own organization, whether it's an unincorporated association, whether it's a nonprofit, which is a nonprofit organization, whether it's a LLC or some type of incorporation or corporation, then you will have to do so on your own accord. Okay? So, let's look at the warehouse receipts. This is Black's Law Dictionary. It says birth certificate now appears to at least qualify as warehouse receipts under the UCC, which is the Uniform Commercial Code. Black's Law Dictionary 7th edition defines warehouse receipts. Check this out. A warehouse receipt, which is considered a document of title, may be a negotiable instrument and is often used for financing with inventory as security. Inventory. So what's the inventory? The citizens.
Mm-hmm.
And what's the security?
The citizens as well.
Exactly. So it's not difficult to see that the state created a birth certificate with the all caps name, which is the straw man or stramius homos. And matter of fact, if you look in Black's Law Dictionary for stramius homo, let's read what it says here. Let's read what it says. Just hold on a second. Let me get to it. Because we got to read it. All right. So it says Latin, stramius homo, a man of straw, one of no substance, put forth as bail or surety. So this name in all caps on the birth certificate is put forth as bail or surety. So that means that in order to get out of jail, which is escrow, you must put forth a birth certificate, which is a negotiable instrument. Dang. Ooh,
wow.
Ooh. Because you can use that, as it says, forward as bail. Remember, they call the person in which that you have to go and see a bail bondsman.
Sure it does.
Right? I don't think y'all caught what I just said.
They haven't.
No, they haven't.
The word bail deals with when you're bailing out water out of a boat. When you're getting ready to ship, you know, bail out of the ship. You're going to bail. You're going to jump ship. That deals with legalese words dealing with Admiralty Maritime Law, which Admiralty Maritime Law is the law of the high seas. That is the law of water.
Right. And the fact is that you are 75% water. So hence, you are within maritime. And plus, you broke from out of your mother's womb, in which they said the water broke.
Yes.
So hence, you was brought to shore. Which means you was brought to the light, brought to the land from out the waters of life. That's why it's called mooring. That's why we are moors, because when you anchor, which is your umbilical cord connected to your mother, as you come out and you're attached to her, that's your anchor. So hence your mooring.
Go ahead, brother.
All right. So let's look at the word bail, and it says, let me find, to procure the release of a person from legal custody. So, we just told you that the birth certificate is a negotiable instrument with the name spelled in all caps on there. You just read stramius homos, which means the man of straw with no substance, put forth as bail for a surety. So that means that you must have a surety. You must be the surety.
Yes.
So your name, your birth name, is the surety. So you must do a affidavit form 28, which is an individual surety, along with that birth certificate. Also, you must do a release of lien on property, on personal property, and a release of what is it? Release of lien from escrow. All right. It's a form 90 and 91. That's what it's called. Optional form 90, optional form 91. Which is one is the release of lien on real property, release on personal property from escrow. All right? Mm-hmm. So you must use all of these particular forms in which that helps, like the Fibonacci number, in which that helps get you out of this predicament in which that you have placed yourself in.
Mm-hmm.
If we understood this, they wouldn't be able to put 65% of us, even though we only make up 6% as black males, as they say, Moors, 6% Moorish males of the population. Well, we make up 65% of the jail rate, the probation, and the parole. Now, how is that possible? You make up more than 65%.
Something's terribly wrong.
Exactly. But if you knew this information that we're talking about, they could even put you in jail because you'll always be able to use your exemption in order to, as it says, bail yourself out. That's what they, isn't that what they call it, Brother L? To bail yourself out?
Okay. Exactly.
That's what they call it. That's what I thought they called it. And what you said that was connected to, was that maritime information you was dropping?
It was the Admiralty Maritime Law, dealing with law of the high seas, the law of water.
And to bail yourself out means basically to get your ass to safety, don't it?
Exactly.
Right? From out the water. Get your ass out the water into to safety of land.
Exactly.
Is that what that means?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You know. So once a state has registered a birth document with the United States Department of Commerce, the department notifies the Treasury Department, which takes out a loan from the Federal Reserve Bank. Uh-oh, I just told you the secret. The Treasury then uses the loan to purchase a bond. The feds hold a purchase money security interest in the bond from the Department of Commerce, which invests the sale proceeds in the stock or bond market. The Treasury Department then issues the Treasury securities in the form of a Treasury bond, notes, and bills. Use the bond as security or surety, for the new securities. All right? So this cycle is based on a future tax renewal of the legal person whose name appears on a birth certificate. This also means that the bankrupt corporate United States can guarantee the purchase of their sureties, the lifetime labor, and tax renewal on revenue of every citizen of the United States with a birth certificate as collateral for payment. This device has initiated simply by converting the lawful true name of the child. All right, which is what? Up in lowercase.
Right.
Into this corporate entity, which they refer to in Black's Law Dictionary as artificial person. Let's look up artificial person. Let's look that up, brother. Artificial person.
All right.
Yeah, we ain't playing tonight. You know, we ain't never play. We ain't never damn play anyway.
No, sir.
Y'all the ones that's been tripping. All right, so here, artificial persons. Persons created, devised by human laws for the purpose of society and government, as distinguished from natural persons. Corporations are examples of artificial persons. One more time. This is Black's Law Dictionary, 4th edition. Artificial persons. It reads, once again, persons created and devised by human laws for the purpose of society and government. So you're not devised by God, but by human law for the purpose of society and government? And distinguished from natural person, a corporation, or examples of artificial persons. So now your name is in all caps. You are the artificial person. You are the corporation.
That's right.
So the question is to those Negroes that tell you not to use the UCC, how do you get yourself from out of that predicament? You ask them that question. What paperwork do you use to get yourself from out of that document, out of that predicament as far as being an artificial person on the public record?
I know no other paper.
Is that, and they can't tell you nothing concerning it. So they're the first ones to holler, don't use it. Because they claim that it puts you back in jurisdiction. No, it doesn't. Because your indigenous appellation, which is your new name and that you have taken for yourself, has no birth certificate in their system.
Exactly.
So you're able to utilize your name, which is your indigenous appellation, some refer to as your free national name, on the documentation, and it has no birth certificate attached to it.
So if you get your corrected name in like a state ID or something like that, even though they have to capitalize it in order to do business or transaction with you, excuse me, they're still, they don't have no birth certificate attached to that name.
Exactly. So therefore, you're still not collateral. You see? Remember, the collateral is the birth certificate. We read that already.
That's right.
All right? That is what passes through the Department of Commerce. That's what passes through the Department of Treasury. That is what is utilized when you go to the copies of which that you get, or not the originals, but that you go to your local registered deeds.
Mm-hmm.
The original is the one which has your footprints, all right, on your birth certificate. You have you have never seen that in years.
Right.
Okay. Your mother hasn't seen that in years. And as a matter of fact, you might not have actually seen that at all.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, once again, ask these individuals who always say not to utilize this information to get yourself out of the predicament in which that they put you into, how to do it. Because regardless on saying that not to use the UCC, which is Uniform Commercial Code, and the reason why I use it is, number one, Obama said it back in 2000. In 8 before his election. Right? He made a speech in Columbia, South Carolina, in which he stated that all African Americans and all United States citizens should study the UCC, which is the Uniform Commercial Code.
So you're telling me something then.
Right, he was trying to tell you some things then, if you was paying attention. But let's go back to the American Banknote Company. All right, let's go back to the American Banknote Company, because let's find out what it is. It has nothing to do with the Bureau of Printing and Engraving. It says the American Banknote Company prints all kinds of documents, and they are a private company. They also have printed currency for foreign governments. The Bureau of Engraving and Printing prints out the paper money and postage stamps for the United States. And they are an agency of the government. All right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, you can actually go to monovista.com. That's M-O-N. D-O-V-I-S-T-A.com. Right. Wikipedia says that the American Banknote Company was a major worldwide engraver of national currency and postage stamps. Currently, it engraves and prints stocks and bond certificates.
Mm.
So, the American Banknote Company is who prints our certificate, which is a bond and stocks. So, they put your ass on the open market on the New York Stock Exchange, which is NYSE, and on the foreign internet on the International Foreign Stock Exchange.
Yes.
Right? It says that actually kind of makes sense, as a bond is a promise to pay by the issuer, person, corporation, or government. It also is a type of shackle. Right? Now, check that out. It's also a type of shackle. So, this birth certificate is not only chattel property, but it's shackles. So, they might have took the chains off of us since slavery, but they have put everyone under this shackle, fake.
Exactly.
Fakeness, as we would say. Okay, so it goes on to read and say, it says without, let's see here, let me read this section. All right. It says, is a birth certificate in itself an instrument, a promissory note, or negotiable instrument of commercial value? The answer is yes.
Yeah.
Is the birth certificate on record at the county and or with the state contract given to states and ultimately the federal government control of all commercial aspects of the individual represented thereon? Does the filing of a UCC, financial statement, addendum, or change statement, amendment, encompasses all commercial, civil, and even criminal activities? Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Does following the steps of the UCC results in giving some value through the federal government without any value being given in return? Right? And it says, is the UCC simply a trick that will only result in retaliation by the government agencies against those who file or participate in the process? And this is no. So, you read and you found that when one files a UCC form and is recorded by the state UCC office, that filing becomes a legal document on the public record identifying the filer as the secure party. Hence, no court can lawfully rule on the fact or existence of the filing itself. That filing is a legal fact. The employees of the UCC Department in each state are fiduciaries required to follow specific rules and procedures. If a UCC violates the specifications of these rules and procedures, the document is to be recorded. There are minor variations in the UCC subsection from state to state and even court country to country, but the bulk of the commercial rules and procedures are universal and uniform, hence the designation Uniform Commercial Code. All right? So it goes on to say that the UCC filing office is located in each state at the union, in each of the territories of the United States. Filing a UCC form is an administrative action that will accept and record by the UCC office. Now, check this out. When the IRS puts a lien on you, guess what they do, brother? Guess what they do, brother L?
Put the lien on you. Well, when they do that,
right,
they put a lien on everything.
Right, right.
Their property.
Right. They do it through a UCC. Right. They do it through a UCC-1 financial statement.
Mm-hmm.
So the same document in which that we're being told not to use is the same document being used against us in order to put us in debt and keep us in debt, perpetual debt. I don't trust these individuals out here saying that shit. So you want to have me in perpetual debt and then have no solution for debt relief. You have no businesses. You have nothing in order to offer as far as protection of individual property and asset. No protection. But yet, you're telling me at the same time not to use it. These some funny people, man.
No, they got some people saying they can use something like numbers.
Right.
They can use, you know, instead of, you know, the numbers of your Social Security or, you know, they say, well, the elite does it to the people, so why can't we do it, you know? That's their answer,
right.
You know.
Right. And see, all of this started in the 1960s, you know what I'm saying, as far as getting information out with the Social Security cards to every person in the home and also the birth certificate. Before the 1960s, you might have found many so-called Negroes that did not even have birth certificates before the 1960s.
Hmm.
And they did not have security cards before then either. Okay.
Wow. So they kind of left them out.
Well, that's because they was trying to figure out if they was able to continue pursuing the running, you know, the run game on us. You know what I'm saying? They was going to be able to see if we were going to go with us being citizens. And when 1955 came in and Martin Luther the King stepped to the plate for civil rights, bypassing human rights, and the reason I told Harry Belafonte that he felt like he was bringing his people into a burning building is because that's what he did. Here you are trying to integrate or you know, to make no longer separate but yet equal, but it didn't come about too well because in the process of making equal, they came up with the term integration.
Mm-hmm.
But yet, as you know, during the Jim Crow days, there was segregation. In other words, we were separate. If you went into a white town or white establishment, you couldn't drink from the water fountain. You couldn't go to the bathroom.
Exactly.
You couldn't eat in the restaurant. Even if you got on the bus, you had to sit your ass in the back.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So many of y'all don't know this. Okay? My mom had to tell me about all of this.
Yeah, my mother did too.
My grandma had to tell me about all of this.
Yep, grandmother, grandfather told me all about that.
Right, you know what I'm saying? I didn't know anything about all that because I came up during the time, you know what I'm saying, of the 70s disco and, you know, by the 80s, Jerry Curls and, you know, Kiko and Atari and shit. You know what I'm saying? Then by the 90s, so Nintendo, you know what I'm saying? And then, shit, by the 2000s, shit, we had Xboxes and, you know, and you know, PlayStations and shit. You know? So we ain't know nothing about all that. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
We ain't had to see those signs saying for white only.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? We ain't had to do all that. But this is what they had to go and be put up and what they put up with. You know what I'm saying? So that they can, you know, so they thought they was finding a better way. But yet, at the same time of integration, we lost hundreds and thousands and thousands and thousands of businesses, black-owned businesses, in which that now we're no longer making any textile in the industry.
No.
All right? So now, being that we're not making anything, you know, because at least then, you know, we had laundromats, we had banks, you know, we were sheriffs. You know, deputies and mayors and, you know, and everything else. Before Reconstruction and after Reconstruction, even during the Jim Crow. I mean, what you think, how you think Rosewood, as well as also Princeville and many other different towns with on Greenway, you know,
yeah.
Tulsa, Oklahoma was able to come about. How y'all think that came about? Even during the Jim Crow time, even during the KKK, you know, we was able to still, you know, do our thing and have businesses. Matter of fact, Tulsa, Oklahoma gave us 36 blocks of mm-hmm. businesses, importing and exporting. We importing and exporting with other countries. And that was what they had stopped, because we was making millions and millions of dollars a day. And if they did not stop us and bomb Tulsa, Oklahoma, by claiming that a so-called youth, a so-called black male, whistled at a white woman in an elevator. That's what they used. That was the excuse they used, some old Rosewood shit. Go and watch the movie Rosewood, and you see the same thing happen. Oh, the nigga did it! The nigga did it! The nigga! That's what they think. They always was talking about the nigga did it. Now they do it now. The nigga's still the first nigga. The first nigga to get killed in the movies is still the nigga.
Right.
The nigga did it.
Oh.
Okay. So that's the same shit, yo. Ain't nothing changed. They still doing the same thing. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Right. They say the beat goes on.
Right. Exactly. So, the kids. Let's continue going on here.
All right. Yeah, man, it's you know, like I said, it gives a new name to crime against humanity, and like I said before, that could be an understatement, and it's just amazing that the majority of the of the Moorish population and around the world, you might as well say, is not even hip what's going on still. And with all the information that's out here for them to find out, I don't know what's going to get them, what's going to take them to, them to get moving or what. Do we have to drop a rock on them or what?
Mm-hmm.
They're still carrying these alien names, voting in them, doing business and transacting business in them, and you know, and they won't correct them. They won't get their names corrected.
Right. But they don't see any value in having a nationality, y'all. That's what it seems to me. You know, will it make any difference? Well, the question is, will living under the fraud make any difference?
It's a big difference.
You know what I'm saying? Right. You know, what difference will it make, you know what I'm saying, for you not to pursue your own? You know, and but yet at the same time, shout revolution, shout Uhuru, shout Black Power, shout Islam, Aslamu Alaikum. They shout all these phrases every day, but yet never declare your nationality. You know, never to put something on the public record in order to counteract what they've done. This is a serious magnitude in which they're talking about, even though, you know, I'm clowning saying some things, but this shit is serious.
Very.
You know? I've been declaring my nationality now for over 10 years. Put it on the public record. You know? I have documents, my affidavit of truth, my affidavit of facts, my nationality, my citizenship, you know, my revoking power of attorney, my denial of corporate status, you know, my live claim birth, baptismal record, all these forms are on the public record.
Yes.
At the registered deeds, in order to counteract the bullshit in which they have perpetrated against us, this fraud.
Yeah. And not only to the county records of deeds, but also to the circuit county courts as well.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. You're going to go to the phone line 347. You're on the air. Area code 347.
Hello.
Peace.
Can y'all hear me?
Yes,
we can.
Loud and clear.
How y'all doing, brothers?
Well.
Doing well.
Very well, brother.
Eileen, brother. I got two questions. My first question is, the school system, is that a form of debt or a form of fulfilling debt? Because I noticed in the school system, you get an OSIS number or a they give you, when they give you the school ID, they give you like that number. And I'm wondering if that's like similar to the birth certificate number or the social security number. I'm wondering, you know, if that's similar or somewhat.
It definitely is a tracking number. But okay. The birth certificate is the only bond number that there is.
All right.
But it definitely is a tracking number. That's what they do. And of course, you know, if you go and read and study Francis Quest Wilson, a teacher, Dr. Lily Fuller, he specifically states, and she states, that there's 9 facets in which they control us at, you know what I'm saying, what they call white supremacy, and education is one of them. Entertainment, sex, labor, law, politics, you know what I'm saying? And this goes on. But there's 9 facets of our lives in which that they control us. And so education is one of those particular aspects. So it's
right.
Tracking up within all of those particular areas in which that I made mention of. But everything is tied back to the birth certificate, which is the only bond, as we heard, as we read, is a notional instrument.
Yeah.
Is a bond.
Right.
Is a warehouse receipt. You know, so, you know, everything is tied back to that. So, you know that for a fact.
Right. And I was also asking that because they say that if you don't send your child to school, that's neglect. So I'm also saying that in such a way that the birth certificate lies as an underlying contract to fulfill, you know, that debt money. You know what I'm saying?
Is that? And that's why the social services is formed in order to go and snatch your child out of the home, in which if you do not abide by that particular contract, then you are in violation, and therefore they send the agents in order to do what they do. You know, and as you said, they'll blame you, say that's neglect.
Yep.
You know, so that's what all of this is about. And all these particular agencies, you know, or modes, you know, modes and schemes, as we would say, for the matrix, these agents is part of the matrix. And the thing about it is that you, me, us, we have to figure out a way in order to be able to move or sail through the 7 seas, to sail through this water, to sail through that morality, this commerce, this marriage con.
Yeah.
If we do not, then we're going to drown. And see, that's why when I point out the fact that we're on the cover of the 101, you know, look on there, Prophet Nabud Ali has 1 foot in water and then 1 foot on land. You know, so that's an attempt to bring us from out of and morality, which is marriage time. You know?
Right.
That's it. It brings us from out of that and brings us back to the Constitution, the constitutional code.
Yeah.
So, but to do so, you have to master the 7 seas. In other words, you have to master morality, you have to master commerce, because that will give you the ability in order to learn business and economics and the science of labor. you know, because that's the realm in which that we're dealing with. So you wonder why we don't have anything of substance, because we do not know commerce, we do not know amorality, law, you know, we do not know contract law, contractual law. So therefore, we are in the back of line. We lag way behind this race. You know, if the race is 400, you know, they started 400 years ago, then we just, you know, got released 150 some odd years ago, then, you know, we are behind, you know. So we have to catch up. And to catch up is by learning the science of law in all the facets, whether it's common law, international law, constitutional law, maritime / amorality, you know, contractual law, equity. We have to learn all these particular signs. It's a must.
Yeah. Shoot, man. I mean, everything within this particular construct of society is rooted in lower individualism. So a lot of those particular elements that you just told me about, it you know, it's hard for the mind that we see now to grasp. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
It's hard for this particular individualistic mind to grasp those elements, because those elements come with the God mind. You know what I'm saying? Admirality and law, those come with a God mind.
Exactly.
And well, my other question was,
that's why they have to know de facto government versus de jure government, colorable law, which is legalities, versus lawful, real law. You know, so we have to know the differences between constitutional law and statutes, codes, rules, regulations, ordinances, which are colorable. You know, and the more we pull ourselves back towards those particular sciences, the best will be. So yes, you have to. The most important thing is nationality. The most important thing is learning the science on how to learn the science of constitutions, whether it's the United States Constitution, whether it's some other type of constitution in which that has been put together by body politics or a group of people. You know, whatever the case may be. You know, it's time for us to definitely learn these sciences, because we sitting back and we getting nothing accomplished, you know, except just saying don't do this and don't do that. But yet there is no system in place so that we can, you know, go to where we need to be at. Everything has to be a process, has to be taken in degrees. So this is just a degree or a tool to be utilized at this time period until we can master what we're supposed to be mastering right now.
Mm-hmm. My other question, right, is, you know, since they have the bond, which you call the birth certificate, that means that you'll own every aspect of your life, including the organs within your body. So this question pertains to the appendix. You know how they talk about the appendix? The appendix doesn't have any function. You know, it has no use. But why the hell does it flare up when you come of an age? You know what I'm saying? So I just want to know if you know any functions of that, you know.
Yeah, it's the your appendix is attached to your liver and your bowel, in which that helps with the removal of toxins and heavy waste materials, such as heavy metals, removal from out the body. You know what I'm saying? Metaphysically, the appendix helps with the manufacturing of the blood supply, the purification of the blood supply, you know what I'm saying, and the plasma. So that's what the appendix does, but yet they claim that it has no function. But they did, but they say that the pineal gland had no function too. But now all of a sudden...
Same exact shit.
Right. Then all of a sudden, now they say, oh, not only is the pineal gland has function, it's the master gland of the whole body.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it excretes chemical DMT, it excretes phenylalanine, it excretes melatonin, serotonin. Damn, it excretes a whole lot of stuff that, once again, they refer to that it had no function. So we understand what they mean by that. You know, right now they're just in the mode of snatching stuff away. Just like they say that what is it called when a child comes to birth?
Is it the thyroid?
No. I'm talking about when the child is being birthed and you have the placenta. That's it. They said that the placenta serves no purpose, you know, in that regard. But yet, you see it in shampoo.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
They crack it be eating that shit on TV when you watch Dr. Phil and Oprah.
Exactly. Yep.
No. And you know who placenta they eating. Come on.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah, and how can the appendix not have no usage? If you look in the book, if you look in reference books, they have an index and an appendix.
Right.
You see? So,
exactly. And the appendix And the appendix.
Oh, the appendix in the book is like it's like the reference the part of the book that gives you the references.
Exactly. So that's what I was saying is that organ helps with the removal of waste and toxins from out the body along with the bowel and along with the liver.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Appreciate you, brother. Thank you.
All right. Appreciate it.
Yeah, see our brothers later. I'll keep listening.
All right, brother.
All right, we got Eric Cole 704. Eric Cole 704. No, 702. You're on the line.
How you doing, brothers?
Fine, please, brother. How you doing, it, boy?
I've been exposed to the information for a couple of years, and I know that nationality is very important. Being out here in Vegas, how can I grab information to get nationalized? And is there a particular website? I know there's no temples out here. Or something
right.
Where I can get all the clear information. Okay, maybe I'll grab this and I'm going to take these steps. And, okay, I got, basically have to, can you do it by yourself or do you need to?
Right. You go to our website. You can go to our website, bro, www.dralimelbay.com. That's DRALIMELBEY, dralimelbay.com. And you can go to the website and check us out. You can go to United Ouachita History and also United Ouachita Reclamation Process.
Okay. Reclamation Process. Mm-hmm. Okay, I got that. Okay, appreciate it. That's my question.
No problem.
Peace.
Peace.
All right, y'all haven't gotten my book yet. I'm telling y'all need it. First World Order. It answers everything concerning this information and plus
yes,
more. Seven chapters of information in which that goes in which that just basically explains everything from the mundane level to the spiritual level. You know what I'm saying? And we did it like that because each chapter symbolizes the awakening of each of the seven chakras or the seven Elohims, mentioned at the seven eyes of Allah. So we did that in order to bring about a change or a transformation. You know what I'm saying? So check us out. Go to the website and check us out. We on there. www.dralimelbay.com. Go to our video link. Aleem and Kadera, YouTube, go to More Heritage, and watch the videos. We go in. So, we definitely getting this information out, so check us out. For those that want to learn more information, you can give us a call at 910-364-9099. That's 910-364-9099. Give us a call. All right, Brother L, you got anything to say before we get up off of here?
Yes, sir, brother. I'm glad we got back on this issue here because I was talking to another brother about the same thing
right.
earlier today and about the birth certificates and why we shouldn't mess with them. Especially
right.
the authenticated one, Noble Tuwa
right.
Ali, told us day one, do not mess with your birth certificate.
Right.
And he knew what he was talking about. The man was a very wise man, no
right.
doubt about it.
Right. Exactly.
And I hope I hope we had done a lot of good. I hope a lot of other people have been listening, and I hope a lot of people really thinking seriously about getting their nationality and birthright, because that's only road to freedom.
No doubt. And understand, go back to the movie Roots. There's so many movies out, you know, since Roots and instead has put this information out, it's ridiculous. So in the movie Roots, you remember that the two overseers, officers, was looking for Kunta Kinte, who ran away, you know, who they referred to Toby. And they ran up on a man and his son on a horse and buggy.
Mm-hmm.
As they ride up next to him on their horses, they have to see his papers. He pulls out his papers. Alex Telly never explains to you what those papers were. And how did he get those papers, being that supposedly slavery was going on? How do you get papers to be free during the time of slavery?
Right.
And the difference, because as you see, obviously was not property, because he was able to own property, which was his horse and buggy. And he was able to ride, you know, through the land, but he had to show his documentation because they didn't tell the difference between the so-called Negro and the Moor, because we both are white, so-called black. So that shows you Kunta Kinte, they find him, they chop off his foot, but the boy and his father on the horse and buggy continues on about their business.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a difference in what's taking place here. And we have had white shriners, Masonic shriners, to walk up on us actually say, are you a Moor? Yes. We're awfully glad that you're waking up.
Mm.
Maybe it helps us with some of the things that we said is taking place in society today.
Mm.
This is what they have told us. This is what they have told us.
Mm.
And these are so-called Masonic shriners here in North Carolina, and we said it's called the Sudan Temple. Now, it's called the Sudan Temple because the word Sudan means the land of the two blacks. And if you get their publications or their material, you will see that it specifically says that Sudan had pyramids and that it was in part of Africa. So what is these white boys holding on to your ancestral information talking about Sudan Temple?
Mm-hmm.
Because they wait for you to come back into consciousness so they're going to have to reveal the information. When my wife and I went to the United Grand Lodge of England, I've told this story several times, and I will continue to tell the story because this shit is important. The curator of the museum portion of the United Grand Lodge of England walked behind us and said, well, how do you feel about the possibilities of your first black president? And me and the brothers started smiling, and by the time we looked at my wife, she said, yeah, but there was none before him.
Hmm.
You know, in other words, there was nine black, so-called black presidents, Moors, before President Obama. So why are you talking about it? He jumps back and says, who told you that? You're not supposed to know that. Did they tell you that?
Mm-hmm.
So once you have experiences like this, you know, and it keeps happening over and over again, you know that you was the secret in Freemasonry, in which they have held on to. And now that you know that you're the secret, now they have to do what they have to do in order for the keepers, I guess you would say, to keep the least amount of people from waking up.
Exactly.
You know? And that's what some white Masonic shriners have taken their oath to, that never to let the Moors rise again. And this is a known fact amongst the, those who study Masonry or who are Mason, whether it's tall, whether it's whatever the case may be, you know, internationally, like Dr. Ben, or whatever, you know, the case is. But this is what is taking place. We're going to go to the phone line, area code 573, area code 573 on the line.
Uh-oh, give me a second, baby, okay? Hello?
Yes,
I'm in Columbia, Missouri, and I was wondering, do you guys have, like, any connections to the conscious, let me see, what do you call it, Because I noticed a lot of seminars are done, but I would like to go up there and possibly get involved in conscious community over there.
Right. Well, Brother L, who's here on the line, he's the Grand Sheik of the Morris Holy Temple of Science in Missouri. So that's the person.
Oh, okay.
So go ahead, Brother L. You want to give her your information so she can contact you and so she can get more info?
Yeah. Oh, yes. You can contact me at my phone number. The home phone number is area code 314. And my phone number is 644-4425. You can contact me. Yes, ma'am. You can contact me and ask me anything you want to know about the Morris Divine National Movement, and I'll be gladly to give you as much as information as I can.
Okay. Now I remember you guys saying something about you were doing a tour or something in St. Louis, I think next month or at the end of this month.
Right. Well, we're going to try to get things together, definitely. We want to, definitely start moving around and start getting this information out. So there's no doubt about that.
Okay,
but
cool.
We're going to say on the radio show when we're going to be out in certain places. That way the people can come out and support.
Yes, yes.
Okay. Well, I'm definitely ready. So
okay.
Glad you guys are going to be close by. Cool.
Okay.
Appreciate
you.
Thank you. Appreciate you, sister. Peace.
All right, and Brother L, for those who don't know, Brother L is in Missouri. He is in Missouri. All right, so definitely check him out and get with him, okay? We had a question, do we have a branch in Southern California? I'm going to have to check. I know we got one in California. I don't know if it's Southern, so I have to definitely check with you, and get back with you. Just listening, and I'm going to definitely give out where you can get in contact with the Morris Holy Temple of Science of the world and, basically how to support this,
mm-hmm.
And also how to get in contact with United Washita. We are Washingtonians also, Any closing remarks, Brother L, before we get up off of here?
Yes, sir. Brother, I can't wait till you get up here in St. Louis, Missouri Public and do this tour that will get a boost to me as well to start off at least be a study class, on a way to build me up a temple.
Right. Exactly.
And like I told you before, with my problems with finding me assistant Grand Sheik and everything.
Right.
But it's coming along. If I have to carry it by myself, that's where I'll do it.
Well, you got people interested. So once you got that, then you're able to definitely keep things moving.
Right. So. I told you about some brothers and the Prince Hall Masonic Lodge that I'm keeping in contact with that also that are more science. Some of them got to keep stay in contact with it because some of them kind of lax off a little bit.
Okay.
Not too consistent having problems with brothers like those, but they're going to come along.
Right.
They're going to have a choice.
Right.
They ain't gonna have no choice, the way things are going.
Right.
Either that or drown.
That's true.
Like I said, I hope we did a lot of good tonight. Like I always say, and those of you who are listening at this moment, get that nationality and that birthright. So you can come out of this slavery, out of this bondage that you're in. And become true men and women. And take your affairs among men.
No doubt. All right, we appreciate you, Brother L, for coming on and checking us out and being our co-host tonight. And, of course, as you do every week, and that's Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, We are here on the First World Order Radio, and we do get down with the information. So we are here every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, 8 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So check us out, y'all. You know, once again,
right.
Go to the website, www.DrAlimElBey, that's DrAlimElBey.com, and go and find out more information about nationality and birthrights, your heritage, find out about reclamation, find out about citizenship, find out about everything that you need to know concerning who you are historically, and show how you are actually linked back to ancient Kemet, all right, and how the word Moors was actually based on information from E.A. Wallace Budgie's book, Egyptian Hieroglyphics, were a group of high priests of the Order of Anu. Anu is a form of Ra, which is biblically Melchizedek, so hence the Order of Melchizedek. So you actually have the group or the Moors being of the Order of Melchizedek. That's actually who we are. So we are the revealers of light mentioned within the Holy Quran, Circle 7.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, you know, it's just about doing your research and study. You know, it's a lot of information. A lot of good information out here. And then there's some disinformation in which that is put in the mix by certain agencies in order to throw you off the course because they don't want you to know about nationality and birthright.
No.
You know? They don't want you to know about the science of commerce and how to operate in commerce properly.
Come back and link yourself with the family of nations.
Exactly. So we're going to leave y'all with that. We're going to say peace to y'all, and we have First World Order Radio. Finally, we are on the air. No doubt. All right.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio.
We get on into some of that Buddha consciousness tonight.
First World Order Radio every Wednesday, 8 p.m.
We got to talk about what is taking place on the planet.
There's always going to be somebody in the building on First World Order Radio. First, we need to let you know we're going to be doing more shows, giving out more information on Wednesdays. Wednesday is 8 o'clock. We are now going to make this is the hottest day of the week.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments. Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance. System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics. Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
Word.
Preceding others in time, order, importance. The most prominent parts, voices, or instruments.
Word.
Earthly state of human concerns in existence. An indefinite multitude, quantity, or distance.
Order.
System regulates to bring about specifics in the group based on value and natural characteristics.
Radio.
Current radiates electromagnetistics of sound through the air, same as your thoughts transmits it.
You need to understand how magical this, something like this every Wednesday can become. So you need to start getting your calendar right, get your schedule right. You need to know our intention straight out.
All right, so, I mean, these clues are given throughout the various languages was to piece the puzzle of this ancient mystery school back together again.
And what we plan on doing, both of us, is bringing y'all some surefire dynamite. We're going to take this level up a notch. We're going to have stuff to do here. This is not just going to be about philosophies and theories, shit that works.